Well, if you care about the preservation of the world's wildlife, then you should mark on your calendar for the 7th Annual Wildlife Conservation Expo, being held next week in San Francisco. 17 of the world's leading animal conservationists will be here to share their stories on saving endangered species. Now, the event is sponsored by the Wildlife Conservation Network. And with me now is the founder and director of the network, Charles Knowles. Hi, thank you for being here.
Thank you,
Rosie. I found this really interesting that 17 experts are flying in to participate in this. So before we get to that, you founded the expo after leaving your job in the Silicon Valley.
Right.
And you turned to wildlife conservation. Why?
Well, it's always been a core passion of mine. I grew up in a rural part of northern Illinois and loved animals. And so when I had this unique opportunity to make a life transition, I wanted to do something involving animals and something international. Mm-hmm. And this led me to this path.
And what is it exactly that the network does? I mean, I know you've got, you know, connections all around the world, but what is the core mission?
Yeah, well, the idea is that we want to save endangered species and save wild places and help the local communities, but instead of a model where we're very centrally based and very top-down, our idea is kind of like the Silicon Valley model. Let's find amazing people who are living and working with these communities, and then just, once you do the careful due diligence, pick the right people, just support the heck out of them, not only with money, but we help them with strategic planning, technology. We connect them with people like Google and really be the eyes and ears for them here in the U.S.
So for them, instead of being out, you know, in the wilds of Africa somewhere trying to raise money and save the animals,
right,
they have a connection to somebody like yourself and the network here
that's right,
supporting their work.
That's right.
Exactly. And helping to move them forward.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
So give me an idea of what's going to happen at this expo, because you're having this expo next weekend,
right,
and all these experts are coming in,
right,
to do what?
Well, what we're trying to do, we do a number of things. We have some fundraising events over the weekend. We have several days where we have conferences and we help them with specific things and people coming in from different high-tech organizations. But specifically on the Saturday, what it is, it's a public education and a networking opportunity. And so each of these 17 incredible conservationists will give a half-hour presentation, and they're not just real technical. They talk about what they're doing to save the animals. They share stories of some of their experiences. Mm-hmm. And people get a chance to meet these people. And they are people like Ian Douglas Hamilton, who was just the feature article in National Geographic this month. Been working there 40 years. You get a chance to hear him and meet him. Mm-hmm. And incredible people working with tigers and cheetahs and snow leopards.
And these are some of the experts around the world. I mean, some of the supreme experts.
Absolutely.
On
yeah,
their specific species.
Absolutely.
That they're trying to
yeah,
work on, right?
Yeah.
We have some photographs just to give people a feeling for the kind of things that we're talking about.
Uh-huh.
All right?
Yeah.
And the first photograph I know is of you and a tribe, a local tribe.
Right. These are Mbutu pygmies in the Democratic Republic of the Congo. These are actually on the staff for the Okapi Conservation Program. They help us there with conserving the okapi.
Okay, and the next picture I believe is
that is the okapi.
That's the okapi.
Yeah.
What is that?
It's actually a forest-based giraffe. Lives in the forest and very unique, very rare species, only found in this part of the world.
Wow, I never knew that it was a giraffe. That's interesting.
Yeah. And this is with Dr. Lori Marker. She runs the Cheetah Conservation Program in Namibia.
Okay, so I have to ask you, this is a wild cheetah?
This is a wild cheetah. It was orphaned, and a farmer had killed its parents, and so Lori adopted the cub and helped raise it. And here's the that same cheetah with a Anatolian shepherd, which we actually use to help farmers protect their livestock.
My gosh, that's great.
And that's a
magnificent elephant.
Yep, that's one of the elephants that Ian Douglas Hamilton works with.
Wow. And then this one's a tragedy that happened.
Yeah, well, this is Ian landing on a runway in the bush in Kenya, and unfortunately that poor zebra on the lower left got in the way. Ian was unscathed. That's the fifth time he's crashed his plane and walked away from all of them.
Oh, my gosh, fifth time?
Yes.
What happened to the plane? My gosh.
Yeah, the plane was totaled, and that's, you know, one aspect of living and working in the bush. It can be really dangerous, and the conservationists at the expo tell their stories about crashed planes and dangerous encounters.
Oh, my gosh, that's incredible.
And that's a baby snow leopard.
I mean, oh, a little fluffball.
Who could not love that?
No kidding. Look at those paws, though.
Yeah.
They're huge.
Well, if you have to walk in the snow, you better have big paws.
No kidding. Wow. Yeah. So, I mean, just a hint of some of the things that we're going to be
right,
seeing and hearing from the experts. So how do you support them? Now, do you raise funds for them?
Yeah, that's part of it. We raise funds, and our model's a little bit unique. We set it up so that 100% of funds that donors designate for a project, we pass directly through. So you know, you can meet Ian Douglas Hamilton, you say you want to support him. If you make a donation of $100, 100% of that ends up in Kenya doing conservation. Wow. So it's kind of a unique model. And to date, we've raised over $10 million and we're supported 20 conservationists working in a total of 30 different countries.
Okay, so most of the photographs that we looked at were based in Africa.
Right.
What other countries are you in? What kind of species are you working with?
In South America, we work in Bolivia, Chile, Peru, and Argentina with a very endangered cat called the Andean mountain cat. We work in Colombia with the world's smallest monkey, a cotton-top tamarin, which we actually have here at the Oakland Zoo. We work in Uzbekistan with Saiga antelope. We work throughout the Himalayan region with snow leopards. We work with small cats in China and Southeast Asia. We're all over the world in developing countries.
And these are all species that are on an endangered species list, or will be, if not saved.
Well, they're all endangered species. And, you know, something unique, Rosie, that we do is it's always about working with local communities. Mm-hmm. You know, you can't, if there's a local community and they can't feed their family or they can't address their own health care needs, they can't be worrying about the species and the environment.
Exactly.
So we're always working with these local communities on economic development. We're always have an educational component. We're always working with health care. We just started a big HIV/AIDS initiative in Africa.
So it's not just about saving the animals, which is important, but you're also saving the environment and the community.
You have to have a healthy community to have a healthy environment.
Exactly. Yeah. Very good. Thank you very much for sharing the information.
Oh,
and
my pleasure.
You know, people can find out more about the expo that's coming up, and it'll be on your screen in just a second. But still coming ahead on Bay Area People, Bay Area children who are looking for a family to call their own. We'll tell you about some of these children, so don't go away. We'll be right back.